Hey learners, Pranshi Verma this side. Welcome to my channel guys. Guys, in today's video we are going to learn solar energy multiple choice question and answer. This is practice set guys for from the subject renewable energy resources, and subject code is ROE087. एंड गाइज, जैसे कि आप जानते हैं मैं आपको प्रैक्टिस सेट ही प्रोवाइड करा सकती हूँ. मेरे को या आपको किसी को नहीं पता एक ट्यूब में किस टाइप का कहाँ से क्या क्वेश्चन आ जाए. जस्ट मैं कहूँगी आप अपने सिलेबस पर फोकस कीजिए, यूनिट वाइज थ्योरी एटलीस्ट अच्छे से कंसेप्ट क्लियर कर लीजिए, एज वेल एज मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर कवर कीजिए जो मैं आपको पढ़ा रही हूँ, या फिर अदर आपको रिलेवेंट लगते हैं आपके सब्जेक्ट से उन्हें कवर कीजिए. सो आपका एग्जाम अच्छे से हो जाएगा एंड पेशेंस के साथ पढ़ाई कीजिए. नाउ लेट्स बिगिन. In this, your first question is, direct solar energy is used for option A, water heating, option B, distillation, option C, drying, and option D, all of the above. Right answer here is option D, all of the above. Okay. Next question, the power from the sun intercepted by the earth is approximately option A, 1.8 multiply 10 to the power 8 megawatt. This is power guys. Second option is 1.8 multiply 10 to the power 11 megawatt. Option C, 1.8 multiply 10 to the power 14 megawatt. And option D, 1.8 multiply 10 to the power 17 megawatt. Right answer is option B, 1.8 multiply 10 to the power 11 megawatt. Okay. Next question, the following is indirect method of solar energy utilization. Option A, wind energy, option B, biomass energy, option C, BEV energy, option D, all of the above. Right answer is option D, all of the above. Next question, a liquid flat plate collector is usually held titled in a fixed position facing blank space if located in the northern hemisphere. Option A, north, option B, south, option C, east, option D, west. Right answer is option B, west. Okay, so a liquid flat plate collector is usually held titled in a fixed position facing south if located in the northern hemisphere. Next question, the collection efficiency of flat plate collectors can be improved by option A, putting a selective coating on the plate, option B, evacuating the space above the absorber plate, option C, both A and B, and option D, none of the above. Right answer is option C, both A and B. Next question, the efficiency of various types of collectors, blank space, with blank space, temperature, option A, increases and decreasing, option B, decreasing, increasing, option C, remains same and increasing, option D, depends upon type of collector. Right answer is option B, decreasing and increasing respectively. So according to this, the efficiency of various types of collectors decreases with increasing temperature. Okay, next question, maximum efficiency is obtained in option A, flat plate collector, option B, evacuated tube collector, option C, line focusing collector, option D, paraboloid dust collector. Right answer is option D, paraboloid dust collector. Next question, the following type of energy is stored as latent heat. Option A, thermal energy, option B, chemical energy, option C, electrical energy, option D, mechanical energy. Right answer is option A, thermal energy. So thermal energy is stored as latent heat. Next question, which of the following type of collectors is used for low temperature systems? Option A, flat plate collector, option B, line focusing parabolic collector, option C, paraboloid dust collector, option D, all of the above. Right answer is option A, flat plate collector. Okay, next question, in the paraboloid dust concept, the concentrator tracks the sun by rotating about option A, 1 axis, option B, 2 axis, option C, 3 axis, option D, none of the above. Right answer is 2 axis. Okay, So in the paraboloid this concept, the concentrator tracks the sun by rotating about two axes. Next question. The sun subtends an angle of blank space minutes at the Earth's surface. Option A, 22. Option B, 32. Option C, 42. Option D, 52. Right answer is option B, 32. Next question. The value of solar constant is option A, 1347 watt per meter square. Option B, guys, ये m की power 2 है यहाँ पर, ध्यान से आप इसको एक समझ लीजिएगा. Option B, 1357 watt per meter square. Okay, and third one is 1367 watt per meter square. And fourth option is 1377 watt meter square. Okay, according to this, right answer is option C, 1367 watt per meter square. Okay, so this is your value of solar constant. This is very important according to me. Next question. The extraterrestrial radiation flux varies by blank space percent over a year. Option A, +-1.1. Option B, +-2.2. Option C, +-3.3. Option D, +-4.4. Right answer is option C, +-3.3. So the extraterrestrial radiation flux varies by +-3.3% over a year. Next question. The following is our laws of black body radiation. Option A, Planck's law. Option B, Stefan Boltzmann law. Option C, both A and B. And option D, none of the above. Right answer is option C, both A and B. Okay, next question. Absorption of solar radiations at Earth's surface occur due to presence of option A, ozone. Option B, water vapors. Option C, carbon dioxide. Option D, all of the above. Right answer is option D, all of the above. Next question. Global radiation is equal to option A, direct radiation minus diffuse radiation. Option B, direct radiation plus diffuse radiation. Option C, direct radiation divided by diffuse radiation. Option D, diffuse radiation divided by direct radiation. Right answer is option B, global radiation is equal to direct radiation plus diffuse radiation. Okay, next question. The zenith angle is the angle made by the sun's rays with the blank space to a blank space surface. Option A, normal and horizontal. Option B, tangent and horizontal. Option C, normal and vertical. Option D, tangent and vertical. Right answer is option A, normal and horizontal. Okay, so the zenith angle is the angle made by the sun's rays with the normal to a horizontal surface. Next question. Solar radiation flux is usually measured with the help of a, option A, anemometer. Option B, pyranometer. Option C, sunshine recorder. Option D, all of the above. Right answer is option B, pyranometer. Next question. Beam radiations are measured with option A, anemometer. Option B, pyrheliometer. Option C, sunshine recorder. Option D, all of the above. Right answer is option B, pyrheliometer. Next question. The angle made by the plane surface with the horizontal is known as option A, latitude. Option B, slope. Option C, surface azimuth angle. Option D, declination. Right answer is option B, slope. The angle made by the plane surface with the horizontal is known as slope. Next question. The angle made is the horizontal plane between the horizontal line due south and the projection of the normal to the surface on the horizontal plane is option A, Hour angle. Option B, declination. Option C, surface azimuth angle. Option D, solar altitude angle. Right answer is option C, surface azimuth angle. Okay, so the angle made in the horizontal plane between the horizontal line due south and projection of the normal to the surface on the horizontal plane is surface azimuth angle. Next question. Surface azimuth angles varies from option A 0 to 90%, option B option A 0 to 90 degree, option B -90 to 90 degree, option C 0 to 180 degree and option D -180 degree to 180 degree. Right answer is option D, -180 degree to 180 degree. Next question. The hour angle is equivalent to option A 10 degree per hour, option B 15 degree per hour, option C 20 degree per hour, option D 25 degree per hour. Right answer is option B, 15 degree per hour. So hour angle is equivalent to 15 degree per hour. Next question. The complement of zenith angle is option A solar altitude angle, option B surface azimuth angle, option C solar azimuth angle, option D slope. Right answer is option A, solar altitude angle. Next question. The correction has a magnitude of blank space minutes for every degree differences in longitude. Option A 2, option B 4, option C 6, option D 8. Right answer is option C 6. Next question. The global radiation reaching a horizontal surface on the earth is given by option A Hawley beam radiation plus Hawley diffuse radiation, option B Hawley beam radiation minus Hawley diffuse radiation, option C Hawley beam radiation divided by Hawley diffuse radiation, option D Hawley diffuse radiation divided by Hawley beam radiation. Right answer is option A, Hawley beam radiation plus Hawley diffuse radiation. Okay, next question. The ratio of the beam radiation flux falling on a tidal surface to that falling on a horizontal surface is called the option A radiation shape factor, option B tilt factor, option C slope, option D none of the above. Right answer is option B, tilt factor. Okay, so the ratio of the beam radiation flux falling on a tidal surface to that falling on a horizontal surface is called the tilt factor. Okay guys, now let's wind up this lecture. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching this video. Please share this video with your friends. Wish you very very all the best for your examination. Bye bye. And at last main yahi kahungi guys, multiple choice question answer ke sath sath please aap apni theory clear kijiye, at least definition level tak sari unit cover kar lijiye, jisse aapka exam bahut bahut acche se ho jaye. Okay, bye. Wish you very very all the best for your examination. Bye bye. And at last main yahi kahungi guys, multiple choice question answer ke sath sath please aap apni theory clear kijiye, at least definition level tak sari unit cover kar lijiye, jisse aapka exam bahut bahut acche se ho jaye. Okay, bye.